Queensland's state election is happening on the 26th of October. Here's five things you should know. Number one, Labor's hold on Queensland could be slipping. It's often said that Queensland is Australia's most conservative state, but Labor has won 11 of the last 12 Queensland elections and has been in power in the Sunshine State for almost a decade. Anastasia Palaszczuk won 3 elections and was an incredibly popular premier, especially during the pandemic. But voters had started to turn on Labor before Palaszczuk retired last year. Things were looking dire, and the new premier, Stephen Miles, has had just 10 months to turn things around. Palaszczuk was a careful and cautious politician, but Miles is throwing caution to the wind. Labor has cut public transport fares, car rego, and power bills. It has taken big risks, like backing out of plans to build new stadiums for the 2032 Olympics. The big question for Labor is whether voters who had turned on Palaszczuk will now believe the government is under new management, or if Labor's garish signs, promising discounts galore, look more like a going out of business sale. Number two, the LNP is going big on law and order. The opposition leader, David Crisafulli, says there's a crime crisis in Queensland, and his big pitch to voters is on law and order. Now, we have to sidetrack for a minute here. Yes, Queensland has some issues with crime, but the idea of a crisis is overblown. Every bit of data shows the long-term crime trends going down, but the media reporting and the political debate has reached a point where the perception has taken hold, and the LNP's campaigning has been very effective. The Conservative Party is promising to introduce adult time for young people in the justice system, even though experts say this might only make matters worse. On almost everything else, the LNP has been vague about its plans or simply tried to neutralise the issue by adopting Labor's policies. Cheap public transport fares will stay, and Crisafulli's even promised to honour Labor's budget over the next 4 years. Labor's been critical of the LNP's small target strategy, but at the same time, Labor's tried the same tactic to try to neutralise anger about crime, adopting several of the LNP's key policies over the last few years, and under Labor, the state locks up more children than anywhere else in the country. Number three, the polls all point to an LNP win. Every poll since last year has shown the LNP is on track for a big win on October 26. The opposition needs to win 12 seats for a majority, and most pollsters predict a swing to the LNP that would likely mean at least 20 seats, possibly more, are on track to change hands. There have been some positive signs for Labor, particularly in the Brisbane suburbs where 50-cent public transport fares are popular. But the biggest problem for the government is that Labor's primary vote looks very low. Even the most optimistic polls show Labor polling at or below 30% on primaries. That's only happened once since the 1950s, and at that election in 2012, Labor was left holding just 7 seats. Number four, the minor parties will have a say. The big storyline from the 2024 election could be the Greens and the Katter's Australia Party, who have each built a strong foothold in Queensland in recent years. The Katters have become the dominant conservative force in North Queensland. They now hold 4 seats and believe they could win more. The Greens now rule parts of Brisbane, where they hold 3 federal seats and are campaigning hard in 6 state seats, including 4 held by Labor, which they think are winnable. The Greens' campaigns have now spread beyond progressive inner city areas to middle suburbs where there are high numbers of renters. Elsewhere, Pauline Hanson's protege, James Ashby, is trying to win the seat of Keppel for One Nation. Number five, Queensland is a complex state. Queensland's the only mainland Australian state where most voters live outside of the capital. There are some very conservative electorates, and also some of the country's most progressive pockets. Sometimes even neighbouring seats swing in opposite directions. The challenge for Labor and the LNP is to try to win votes in Mount Isa and Mount Coober, in Townsville and Toowong, where people often want very different things. Labor's stronghold is in Brisbane, where the LNP holds just 4 seats. But the places that will determine who forms the next government are in the regions. and expect the leaders to spend plenty of time in Cairns and Townsville, especially early in the campaign.